my regular regular time. Sorry. Just give me a moment, please. Sadashiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashyakritam Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punaha Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Yoma Vatvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Om Sahanavavatu Sahanau Punaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavati Tamastuma Vidvishavahai Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi यो ब्रह्माण विजाति पूर्व वेदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवम् आत्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं शुरुहि शरणमहं प्रपद्ये शांति शांति शांतिः श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बोध्यं बुद्धे दृक्यत्व निरुपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परम तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः So Ajnana was said to be specific and thereby the Badha is also specific. So that question was answered. Now Samsara Vishayaka Vichara. Since Samsara has been mentioned as to why a particular kind of behavior is there in Samsara, that kind of a question was indicated. I mean, the samsara was in the context in passing, it was inquired into. Therefore, samsara vishayaka vicharaha. We'll come back to the tippana. Not marked it. We'll come back to the tippana. I'm sorry. So please bear with my cough. Samsara vishayaka vicharaha samsara utpatti kama prashna. So the question, which is, I mean, not asked directly, but something which should be looked into in the context. But before that, okay, let's finish the tippana because the topic is changing a bit. So here, what was said here, in the question here, I was just looking at where is the point number one. That's why I mark it. Somehow I miss it. Anyway, let's go to this. Ghatadi nikhila anatma jadapadartha upahita chaitanya avarika avidya tula vidya ityuchyate. So tula vidya, mula vidya has been mentioned earlier also, and footnote also had given a sankshepa as to how panchapadikara treats tula vidya. He does not say tula vidya is different. Everything is mula vidya. Tula vidya is that vidya, otherwise that avidya which veils the individual padarthas. Whereas mula vidya can be called as maya, which veils the atma, brahmatma. So ghata avarna, ghata vishaya avarika will be Tula Vidya. But Panchapadikara does not. Yeah, okay. So this Panchapadikara does not make a difference. Thank you, Venkateshji. Yeah. So it is the footnote for Pratibhasika Saptaya. So I was just looking at the line where it is. Yeah. So okay. So Pratibhasika Satta. This Pratibhasika Satta is mentioned. Under that, there is this footnote. So Ghatadi Nikhila Anatma Jadapadartha Upahita Chaitanya Avarika. Avidya, tula vidya iti uchyate. What is tula vidya? It is avidya, of course, and it is avarika, means it causes avarna. आवरण ऑन वॉट ऑन चैतन्य बट दैट चैतन्य विच इज उपहित घटादि निखिल अनात्म जड़ पदार्थ उपहित दैट चैतन्य विच इज विच हैज एन उपाधि वॉट इज द उपाधि फॉर द चैतन्य शरीर इज द उपाधि वेन वी जनरली टॉक अबाउट जीव माया इज द उपाधि वेन वी टॉक अबाउट ईश्वर विराट पुरुष और द हिरण्य गर्भ हैज उपाधिज घटादि निखिल अनात्म बेसिकली वॉट जड़ पदार्थ प्रपंच प्रपंच बट इंडिविजुअल ऑब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ द विषयास ऑफ द प्रपंच सो घटादि निखिल अनात्म जड़ पदार्थ उपहित चैतन्यावारक अविद्या तुला विद्या इति उच्यते इयम् एव अवस्था ज्ञानम् अवस्था अज्ञानम् इति सादि मलिन अविद्या इति च कथ्यते सो देयर आर वेरियस टर्म्स यूज्ड फॉर तुला विद्या साच तुला विद्या अंश भेदेन नाना भूत्वा भिन्न भिन्न पदार्थावारिका भवति ऑल्दो इट इज सिंगल तुला विद्या इट इज वी डोंट से तुला विद्याः इट इज तुला विद्या वन अविद्या बिकॉज फाइनली अविद्या इज ऑल्सो वन चैतन्य इज ऑल्सो वन देर इज नो डिफरेंस इन चैतन्य सिमिलरली देर इज नो डिफरेंस इन अविद्या ऑल्सो अविद्या इज द सेम माया सो तुला विद्या एंड मूला विद्या हैज बीन टॉक्ड अबाउट सो तुला विद्या इज कैन बी वन बट इट इज सेपरेट फ्रॉम मूला विद्या नाउ देर इज मतभेद हियर सो दिस साच तुला विद्या अंश भेदेन नाना भूत्वा बिकॉज देर आर विषयस आर मेनी therefore these are also talked about as having aunshas not these this avidya this tula vidya is also said to have many manifestations because there is ausha bheda so ausha bhedena nana bhutva bhinna bhinna padartha avarika bhavati therefore it is particular kind of avidya although tula vidya is one but still ausha bhedena when you look at ghatau घटा अंशे वेन यू टॉक अबाउट घटावारिक तुला विद्या पट अंशे पटावारिक तुला विद्या देयरफॉर द ज्ञान इज ऑल्सो पर्टिक्युलर ज्ञान इट डज नॉट गिव आत्मज्ञान ओनली अ पर्टिक्युलर अविद्या गोज अवे अदर पर्टिक्युलर अविद्याज आर देयर इवन इन घटा वेन अ पर्टिक्युलर पॉट इज नोन देन अनदर पॉट इज अननोन Another pot avidya continues to be there, tula vidya. Whereas one pot avidya is gone. One may say that I know the pot. If one has never seen a pot, ghatatvam kim, that is known with one vyakti ghataha. So ghata vyakti makes you to know the ghata jati. Thereby ghatatvam is known, but a particular ghata, one ghata, this size, this colored, that has अंश भेदेन तुला विद्या भेद सो नाना भूत्वा यदा यत् पदार्थाकार अंतकरण वृत्तिरुदेति तदा तत्पदार्थावारक तुला विद्यांशः नश्यति सो ओनली दैट तुला विद्या रिलेटेड टू अ व्यक्ति वन इंडिविजुअल ऑब्जेक्ट गोज अवे through what through antakarana vritti so antakarana vritti which is jnana roopa vritti vidya roopa vritti that counters one tula vidya yada tu antakarana vritti padarthantaram anudhavati however when the mind goes elsewhere you have seen the pot and then you see something else in fact in bhashya somewhere bhagwan bhashyakara says as and when you are looking at a horse then there is ashwavritti but behind that horse let's say there is a buffalo the horse starts to move a little the buffalo is seen behind then it's an example to drive home the point how vishayakara vritti is continuously taking place and it shifts the vritti shifts from one vishaya to another vishaya thereby the vritti changes Vritti changing the avidya which was countered earlier, ashva avidya goes away, but mahishi avidya is still there. The buffalo avidya is still there. That goes away when you see that. There is the buffalo akara vritti, mahishi akara vritti takes place and ashva akara vritti goes away. And similarly it is with, I mean, other shabda ityadi. Now what is happening here when you talk about tula vidya, aunsha bhedena nana bhutva, it appears in many fold ways. So there is particularized avidya. That goes away, the other avidya continues. And not only that, when the ashva, the pramana shifted from ashva to mahishi, then the ashva buddhi goes away. There the language used in bhashya is ashva buddhi. Ashva buddhi goes away, mahishi buddhi comes in. When ashva buddhi goes away, as long as ashvakara vritti was there, ashva buddhi was there, the ashva was known, meaning the ashva ajnana was countered. But as soon as that ashva went away, since the vritti is not there, that vrittyatmaka jnana isn't there, ashva buddhi isn't there, therefore the ashva ajnana continues. Although the ashva is known, but ashva ajnana continues at that moment because you are having the mahishi buddhi. So that is the example which drives home the point of how this avidya works. Yada tu antakarana vrittihi padarthantaram anudhavati goes to some other vishaya padartha tada punarapi purva padartha varka tula vidyayaha anyo aunshaha utpadyate. So this tula vidya is not nashta at all. At that moment it went nashta in the sense tula vidya, the earlier tula vidya is gone, the new tula vidya has come. What is that newness there? In Vedanta, we consider the, I mean, we don't agree with the vritti being kshanika. Nayayika says the vritti is kshanika. But we don't, to answer the Nayayika, we say, okay, vritti is kshanika. Hypothetically, let's say, you know, for argument's sake, let's agree. But still the vritti that follows is new. New in the sense, you don't have to bring, I mean, there is a argument there, let's not go there, but the kala amsha is new. If the padartha is same, how can the padartha remain the same and vritti be different? That is because the kala amsha is differentiated. Kala bhedena vritti bheda. That is hypothetically accepted. But then Vedantin says that as long as the Vishaya continues to be same, although there is a Kala Bheda, for us, we don't have to talk about different Vrittis. A shorter method, Laghavam is there to consider it as a single Vritti. So that's why Ashva Buddhi is talked about by Bhagavan Bhashyakara, not at a particular Kala. As long as Ashva is there, be it for, you know, 1 moment or 10 hours, irrelevant. The vritti continues to be here. Now this is again theoretical because it is not only the ashva that you are looking at through and through. There is shabda that you are listening to. So the vritti keeps on shifting from vishaya to vishaya. Vishaya changes, the vritti changes. That being so, when the earlier padartha or vishaya is known and the buddhi shifts elsewhere, padarthantaram anudhavati, antakkarana vritti. Then what will happen? The earlier vritti goes away. Therefore, punarapi purva padartha avarakaha tula vidyayaha anya aunshaha. Another aunsha, because aunsha bhedena has been mentioned, so another aunsha of tula vidya crops up. And then it veils the purva padartha. That is why you don't know the purva padartha again. If you look at it, you need another vritti. Otherwise, the earlier vritti has taken away ajnana, the prakriya won't work. So what is said is the purva padartha avaraka tula vidya anya ausha utpadyate. Eta adrusha tula vidya ausha nashaya na brahma jnana peksha. So the question which was asked, why is it that there is a brahma jnana apeksha for vyavaharika padartha एंड नॉट फॉर प्रातिभासिक पदार्थ बिकॉज बोथ आर मिथ्या ब्रह्म भिन्नत्वेन सिंस ब्रह्म इज डिफरेंट ऑल ऑफ दीज आर डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म वेदर इज प्रातिपादिक प्रातिभासिक विषय और इट इज अ व्यावहारिक विषय पदार्थ डिफरेंस इज बिकॉज तूला विद्या इज डिफरेंट सो एतादृश तूला विद्या अंशनाशाय न ब्रह्मज्ञान अपेक्षा मिथ्या पदार्थ विच इज व्यावहारिक वेर यू हैव टू कॉग्नाइज इट एंड डू व्यवहार देर वृत्ति इज देर बट इट इज नॉट ब्रह्माकार वृत्ति इट इज अ पर्टिक्युलर घटाकार वृत्ति पटाकार वृत्ति अश्वाकार वृत्ति इत्यादि तस्य तूला विद्यांशस्य प्रातिभासिक सत्ताकत्वात् घटादि तत्तत् पदार्थ ज्ञानेनैव नाश संभवति नाउ दिस तूला विद्या हाउ कैन तूला विद्या टेक अवे व्यावहारिक पदार्थ अविद्या सॉरी तूला विद्या हाउ डस तूला विद्या गो अवे बाय ब्रह्मज्ञान इतर ज्ञान सो ब्रह्मज्ञान इतर ज्ञान टेक्स अवे तूला विद्या सो देयर ही सेज तस्य तूला विद्यांशस्य प्रातिभासिक सत्ताकत्वात् तूला विद्या इज प्रातिभासिक देयरफॉर घटादि तत्तत् पदार्थ ज्ञानी नैव नाश संभवति सो एनीवे यू टेक व्यावहारिक और प्रातिभासिक दी सत्ता बीइंग सेम इट काउंटर्स दी अविद्या तूला विद्या एंड देयर बाय नाशा टेक्स प्लेस नाउ इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ही ब्रिंग्स अप the difference between tula vidya and moola vidya and whether it is acceptable panchapadika panchapadika krutah tu evam ahuhu so panchapadika kara says moola vidya eva tula vidya there is no difference between the two na tato atirikta iti tanmate yatha janasamudaya madhye ashanipate sati tada tatrastha janaha ततः अपसरन्ति सो ही गिव्स एन एग्जांपल देयर इज अ लाइटनिंग एंड देयर इज अ फायर ड्यू टू लाइटनिंग एंड पीपल आर स्टैंडिंग देयर दे विल ऑब्वियसली रन अवे फ्रॉम देयर सो द फायर इज देयर दे रन अवे फ्रॉम द फायर क्रिएटेड बाय लाइटनिंग और व्हाटएवर यू नो अशनिपाते तदा तत्रस्थ जनाः ततः अपसरन्ति इट इज नॉट दैट दे हैव गॉन अवे दे वोंट कम बैक दैट प्लेस If there is fire, when the fire goes away, they come back again. Paschat tatra punarapi janaha sammilanti. Tatha yada yatpadartha akara antakrana vritti rudeti. Tada tatpadartha akara vidya tataha tirobhavati. Similarly, when there is antakrana vritti, jnana, vidya, then that padartha yatpadartha akara antakrana vritti rudeti. That very padartha ajnana will go away, nothing else. So that tula vidya goes away, avidya goes away. Avidya and mula vidya, you don't have to differentiate. He says, yada tu antakkarana vrittih padarthanta akara bhavati, tada punarapisa avidya puro padarte prasrutat tam avrunoti. Now he says, you don't even need to consider a new amsha of avidya. It is the same avidya which wails back again, just like People go away, the same people can come back. Those who know that there was a fire, they are the ones who are going to come back and see what damage it has done or whether to put out that fire, whatever. So it's the same people who come back. You may think that people went away and more people came, but they are the same people. So since that is a possibility, similarly, antakkarana vritti takes away avidya. When the vritti goes away, that avidya comes back again. परंतु ब्रह्मज्ञानम विना न तस्या अविद्या नाशो भवति बिकॉज़ ही सेज दैट इट दैट इज तूला विद्या टू यू इट इज तूला विद्या दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू थिंक अबाउट एन अंश भेद बिकॉज़ वंस अज्ञान हैज गॉन अवे हाउ कैन इट कम बैक दिस विल बी द क्वेश्चन If ajnana goes away, it will not come back. If at all you accept that the same avidya has come back after going, then how is it that you expect moksha to be nitya? Because ajnana going away, maybe it will come back again. That is why you have to think of an ansha bheda. He says, in this case, I don't have to think of ansha bheda. There is laghavam. He says, mula vidya and tula vidya are same. The mula vidya does not ever go away. Therefore, avidya never goes away unless there is brahma jnana. What is happening in this case is, momentarily it appears to have gone because of vritti, but it is not nashta. It will come back when your focus changes elsewhere. It comes back. And that avidya will go away only when there is brahma jnana. So parantu brahma jnana vinana tasya avidya nashaha bhavati evameva swapna padarthanam pratibhasika rajju sarpadescha avidya nasham antarana antarena eva virodhi padarthantara jnanena va avidyayah tirodhanena va avidyayam layarupo nashaha va tirodhanam va bhavati. So either it subsides for a moment or it can completely go away. But atra prasanga tula vidya varnanam krutam. So in the context, he has just mentioned it, meaning there's not much focus needed here. However you take it, you have to land on moksha nityattvam and you should be able to explain the prakriya. So whichever prakriya works for you, you can hold on to that. In vivarana, this mula vidya finally will be said to be same as tula vidya. There is no difference. There are no ansha bheda. All this is, that itself is mithya. Because all this is, the explanation is mithya, guru is mithya, Upanishads are mithya, all these explanations definitely are all mithya. Even pratibhasika, that is why pratibhasika has been mentioned here. This is a little, you know, tula vidya amshasya pratibhasika satta kattva. Finally, everything is pratibhasika. There is no vyavaharika satta at all. Vyavaharika satta is pratibhasika. It is used only to explain to people who have difficulty to understand that there is mithyatvam. This mithya shabda has the meaning of false also. So if you say false, then people have an ego issue. How can I be moved? How can I be deluded? So there is a question, how this vyavaharika satta, you know, they'll even argue, why don't you give your money to me if it is mithya? So mithyatvam itself is misunderstood. To those people, the Upanishad brings in Vyavaharika Satta. See, it's Vyavaharika Satta, okay, it is there. And therefore, Samsara Vishayaka Vicharaha. What is this Vyavaharika Satta? Ishvara Krita Padartha. All this is in, it is for Madhyama Mooda Adhikari. Madhyama Adhama Adhikari, which is the majority. Majority of us are there. It is not that we are Uttama Adhikaris. So as long as Adhikaritvam is there, we are moving towards the goal. So it is fine. Whichever prakriya works to get us there. Finally, our swartha is moksha, not in becoming Adhikari. The goal is not to become an Adhikari. The goal is not to become a Karma Yogi. The goal is to get moksha. So it is irrelevant as to whether I get it through this prakriya or that prakriya. Finally, jnanena moksha. Samsara utpatti krama prashna. So what is that? Samsara utpatti krama prashna. Brahma jnanad utpadyamana samsara kena kramena utpadyate iti sunishchitam varnaniyam iti shishyo gurum prichati. So guru asked by the shishya. Shishya asked the guru. Kartari prayoga. So shishya asked the guru, give me a definite answer. Is there a krama to this samsara creation? Whether it is creation, manifestation, utpadyamana, it rises because in my vritti I have samsara. Samsara dukkha vritti is there. I want nivarana of samsara dukkha vritti. Then, is there a krama to samsara? Purva prashnasya guru uttaram. What does the guru give the answer as? Swapnavad vinakramam jagatah pratitihi. This is Siddhanta, okay? Siddhanta is there is no krama. Well, how can you say that? Immediately, as soon as you say there is no krama, people will, even Vedantins will be, you know, picking up sticks, because how can you counter Bhashya? Bhagavan Bhashyakara says it is not random. In in the Upanishad, I think in Mundaka Upanishad, he says there is a krama to the srishti. I think in Chandogya maybe. I don't remember where exactly. But there is a krama prashna. He says it is not random. So, like the Bhadra Mushti. So you throw a handful of strawberries or something, berries. If you throw handful of berries, they'll go and fall anywhere. There is no krama there. Which berry will fall first, which will fall later. So he says it is not random. There is a krama. If there is a krama, then there is a samsara krama prashna, which is explained in Taittiriya, in Chandogya, in Mundaka. The Upanishads talk about it, but then they talk about it differently. In Taittiriya, it is said as there is a krama with panchikarana. In Taittiriya, there are only three yus. But there is a krama in those three. Here, there is a krama in these five. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakara fills the gap because there is a Purva Paksha. He himself does not say that, okay, this is how this Srishti is. It has a krama. It has a definite krama. It should be in this manner only. When he is explaining, he has an audience in mind. So, the Purva Paksha has the question as to why there are only three Mahabhutas here and there are five Mahabhutas in the Taittiriya Upanishad. So, the question needs an answer. And there is a Srishti Prakriya going on. He cannot say the Srishti is all bogus there. Because he has not landed on the Apavada yet. There is an Adhyaropa. People hold on to this Adhyaropa. Adhyaropa has no commitment from the Upanishad. The Upanishad Tatparya is not with the Adhyaropa. You need not stop there. You shouldn't stop there. You have to go beyond to Apavada. Thereby the Krama is Mithya. Krama is Mithya. And once you know that, then alone you can land on the Jnana. You cannot say, no, it has to be this way. The creation is exactly this way. And then you say it is also Mithya. It helps Mithyatvam. And to help understanding Mithyatvam, this Srishti is particularly talked about in different Upanishads in different ways. So that if you study more, then you can land on the Mithyatvam easily. Why does it talk in such a manner? Because it is all an answer given to an audience of a particular kind. Whatever works for you, pick that. But then both of these are not real. In fact, in Mundaka Upanishad, it is said that there is a krama is mentioned, then the krama changes. And then Bhagavan Bhashyakara explains there is that everything is born from Ishvara. So it is not, there is no krama, but everything is directly born from Ishvara. So it's a flat hierarchy, you know, in the corporate language, it's a flat hierarchy. So this is the question here to which the answer is given. Krama, samsara, krama, prashna, swapnavad, vinakram, jagatav, pratitihi. Everything pops up at the same time in the swapna. How did it come about? We have no questions. There is no krama inquiry also. We assume that the world is like this. How did it come about? It just cropped up like that. Svapna padartha yatha kramamantarena api utpadyante tadva deva mithya jagat pratibhasate mithya jagat kramajinyasu marichikodaka avagahanam api ichchet. So one who wants to inquire into the krama of samsara utpatti krama, they spend their entire life, but then still they'll not get an answer. This is what Bhagavan Karikakara says. Bhagavan Gaudapadacharya says that those who focus on the krama prashna, samsara krama, what happened to this? Is it a leela? Has it come from Shiva or Vishnu? What is it? I mean, who created it? In which way it was created? All these they are committed to their Srishti Chintaka. I think the word he uses is Srishti Chintaka. So when you say Srishti Chintaka, they are not Tattva Chintaka. Srishti is very easy to get lost in the details. Even to understand Ishvara, person who wants to understand Ishvara, Vaishnavas say that Ishvara is Ananta Gunavan. Ananta Kalyana Gunavan, not just Guna, Ananta Kalyana, only good. There is nothing bad in Ishvara. So if you want to know all the good, even then it is impossible. Because Ananta, Ananta Janmas also you do Upasanas, you can never know Ishvara. Saguna Brahma can never be known. Similarly, Srishti Krama, you are wasting your time. The Upasaka who wants to know all gunas of Ishvara will never get there. He'll know his Ishta Devata, Upasya Devata, that too in a particular aspect. No, I like only Bala Krishna, not this Leela Krishna. I like this Bala Krishna. So it's all Srishti Chintaka will remain there. They don't move to Apavada. Therefore, those who are inquiring into Srishti, they are the ones who will be inquiring into the mirage water. So, Marichikodaka Avagahanam Api Ichet. They will also want to know the how did this come about and details there. That has nothing to do with the Tattva. Because it is not the commitment at all. Upanishatsu Jagadutpattihi Anekada Varnita. Why do you say so? Because it is not, how do you know it is not the Tatparya? It is mentioned in various ways. There is no Abhyasa there. It does not fit into the Shadalinga. In Shadalinga, there has to be an Abhyasa. It should be repeated in the idea and should be repeated. It is not repeated. It is said differently in different Upanishads. That is not repetition. Upanishatsu Jagadutpattihi Anekada Varnita Jagrasvapnayo Sarvata Samyam Eva Shruyate. So Jagrasvapnayo Sarvata Samyam Eva. If you compare, how I so Swapna Padarthaha Yatha Kramamantarena Api Utpadyante. Similarly, Jagrat Swapnavat Mithya. Because of not having Krama. Krama Antarena Utpattehe. That's Hetu. Or Kramamantarena Utpatti Varnita. Therefore, Ataha. Ataha Jagrat Swapnayoho Sarvatha Samyam Eva Shruyate. Samyam Kim Mithyatvam Pratibhasikatvam Tasya Treya Avastha Tasya Treya Avastha Avastha Treya Swapna. Oh yeah, so this is a quotation there. Tasya Treya Avastha Treya Swapna. Aitari Upanishad says this. Ata Eva Tatra Yugapat Srishti Api Ukta. So, Yugapat Srishtirapi Ukta. It is not that there is only Krama in all Upanishads. In one Upanishad, there is some Krama. In another Upanishad, some other Krama. And Yugapat Srishti is also talked about in some Upanishad. It came about suddenly. Just like Swapna. Sa Iman Lokan Asrujat Iti. How so? Saha Iman Lokan Asrujat. Lokan Asrujat. He created it. There is no Krama mentioned there. Everything came about. Sa idagum sarvam asrujat. There's a typo here. Sa idagum sarvam asrujat. Jadi zankincha. Taittiriya Upanishad says that. So he created. There may be Krama iticha. Tathaya panchadashyam apyuktam. And panchadashi also negates this idea of Tatparya being in the Srishti. I'll just go through this. We'll not go into details. We get an idea as to what is the Tatparya of the Shruti there, and what about Shrishti? What is Shrishti there? Swapnendra Jala Sadrisham Achintyar. Let me try to get the tune right. Swapnendriya Jala Sadrisham Achintya Rachanatmakam Drishtanashta Jagat Pashyan Katham Tatra Anurajyati. Swapni Indra Jala Sadrisham. It is all Indra Jala Sadrisham or Swapna Vat Mithya. Indra Jala is magic. Achintya Rachanatmakam. It may be mind-boggling. Mayaya Sarvasya Sambhavat. Everything is possible. Due to Maya, everything is possible. Yugapat Srishti possible. क्रमेण सृष्टि पॉसिबल रज्जु सर्पवत इजर क्रमाह रज्जु सर्प केम स्वप्नवत दृष्टनष्ट स्वभाव इट इज दृष्टनष्ट जगत द जगत विच हैज दृष्ट नाउ दृष्ट देन नष्ट एवर चेंजिंग जगत पश्यन कथम तत्र अनुरज्यति हाउ कैन वन रिजॉइस इन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ मिथ्या प्रपंच स्वस्वप्नम अपरोक्षेण दृष्ट्वा पश्यन स्वजागरम चिंतयेद अप्रमत्त सन्न सन्न चिंतयेद अप्रमत्त सन्नुभावन उदिनम मुहुः आई डोंट देयर मे बी अ टाइपो हियर और आई एम नॉट गेटिंग इट राइट बट एनीवे स्वप्न स्वस्वप्न अपरोक्षेण दृष्ट्वा इट इज अपरोक्ष बट इट्स योर ओन स्वप्न विच इज अपरोक्ष टू यू दिस प्रपंच इज ऑल्सो लाइक दैट इट इज अपरोक्ष टू यू इट इज मिथ्या यू कैनॉट से दैट यू कैनॉट इनफैक्ट देर इज नथिंग दैट कैन डिफरेंशिएट द स्वप्न एंड जागृत वन मे से लॉन्गर ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम कंटिन्यूएशन एंड ऑल दैट दिस इज ऑल नॉट a strong point to say that it is real because the continuity is not really a comparison in the right time frame. Time frames are different. The continuity question can be asked, the Jagrat continuity can be questioned by looking at from a broader perspective across Janmas. Where is the continuity in Jagrat Prapancha? Across Janmas. In Janma, the Sharira is different. In Swapna, across Swapnas, the Sharira is different. Therefore, there is no continuity. But in the same Janma, in the same Swapna, as a Janma, if you compare that with the entire Jagrat Janma being the Swapna Janma, then in that Swapna Janma, there is some continuity. No, but something is happening, then something else is happening. Yes, but something else is happening. If there is no continuity, why don't you question it during the dream? It is all real. It may be confusing, but then so is Jagrat. Something suddenly happens, you say, I don't know. I mean, suddenly the entire prapanch, look at the current situation in COVID. Nobody imagined this. Suddenly the entire world has completely changed. You cannot continue to the way that you can continue in the prapancha. The way you were continuing earlier, you cannot continue. So you have to think 10 times before you step out. How did this happen? Mind-boggling. Maya sarvasya sambhavat. So the continuity in the Jagrat Prapancha is not a valid point. People think it is a valid point. It is not, because across Janmas there is no continuity. This is the same reason that there may not be continuity across Swapnas. Not only this, just because one person does not see continuity does not mean that there is no continuity for everyone. One Sringeri Acharya, the earlier Acharya to the current Acharya, Bhagwan Abhinav Vidya Tirtha Swamiji, when he had Sannyasa Diksha at age 13, the very same night he had the dream of Shiva. So Shiva came out of Kailasa and started teaching yogasanas to Sringeri Acharya. And it continued the next day, and the next day, and the next day. It continued till he learned the asanas more than all the entire Hatha Yoga Pradipika put together. All these asanas were taught by Bhagwan Shiva himself. Ishvara himself taught him. Now there was continuity across Swapnas, mind you. Across Swapnas, there was continuity. It ended only when, in the first dream, he came and gave the asana to sit. He just said, sit on this. Right? Said or whatever he showed. And then he showed the asanas, or he taught the asanas. Then it continued the same way across days, across dreams, across nights, across dreams. And then in the last dream, after everything was taught, Shiva walked away into Kailasa again. So this is a dream continuity across. So this is used only for people who don't understand, have Shraddha, but they don't understand the continuity. They question the difference. They assert the difference by bringing about this continuity aspect. So it can be countered that way also. It can be countered by saying across Janmas there is no continuity. You will not see. You don't remember even. Just like you don't remember in waking itself, you don't remember the dream. All of us dream, but very few of us and very few dreams we remember. That too not in its entirety. Similar to not knowing the anything of the earlier Janma, unless there is some Puro Samskara where a person remembers the earlier birth. But then there is no continuity at all. Chirantayo sarvasamyam anusandaya jayate satyatva buddhim santyajya nanurajyati purvavat. So he quotes all this. Panchadasya api uktam. This is, so it is, all these ideas are in the Upanishads. They are brought about by Panchadashikara. Satyatva buddhim santajya, having given up the satyatva buddhi, because chirantayo sarvasamyam, between the swapna and jagrat, there is sarvasamyam. Everything is same. Anusandaya jayate satyatva buddhim santajya anurajyati purvavat. Nidra kalpita deshakala vishya jnatradi sarvam yatha mithya tadvad ihapi jagrati jagat swajnana karyatvatah yasmadevam idam sharira karana pranaham adyapyasat tasmat tattvamasi prashantam amalam brahmadvayam yatparam. So the meters change. There is a difficulty in chanting. As it is, I have trouble shifting from prose to some chandas in chanting. Then across also, if it changes, then you know, across slokas also. In Viveka Chudamani, it is like that. So there is a difficulty in chanting these, getting the chandas at the right moment. That is the problem. So Medha is lacking, unfortunately. But you get the idea. Nidra Kalpita Deshakala. Like in Dakshinamurti Stotra also. That meter will fit in. But then to shift from one meter to the other is little tricky for me. So Nidra Kalpita Deshakala Vishaya Jnatra Adin Sarvam Yatha Mithya. All of this is Mithya. Tadvad Ihapi Jagrati Jagat Swajnana Karyatvataha. That therefore it is Mithya. Tasmad Evam Idam Sharira Karana Pranaham Adyapi Asat. Everything, all the koshas are Mithya Asat. Tasmat tattvamasi, you are that satpadartha. Everything other than you is mithya prashantam amalam brahma advayam yat param. That you are. Svapnerthi shunye srijati svashaktya. There is a typo here. Bhoktradi vishwam manayeva sarvam tathaiva jagratyapi no vishesha tat sarvam etan manaso vijrumvadam ityadina choktam. So Karika says that. Karika says that manasa vijrumbhanam, this is entire thing is the mind. Prapancha is in the mind. Antakarana manaeva sarvam vishwam bhoktradi vishwam manaeva. There is no reality. Just like swapna. Bhokta in the swapna, bhokta in jagrat avastha, both are mithya. They are all manifestations of the mind. Antakarana. The antakarana itself is mithya. But then, antakarana has the vrittis of the prapancha, whether it is swapna prapancha or the jagrat prapancha. Tatha eva jagratyapi no vishesha, nau visheshaha, no vishesha. There is no difference which we need to bring in. Swapnavat mithyatvam is definitely there. Artha shunya, there is no really, this is not shunyavada, mind you. Artha shunya has been said. Artha shunya is different from sarva shunya. So people who misunderstand this, even the Vedantins, Advaitins, they say, no, it is not Buddhism. Yes, we know it is not Buddhism. No, you cannot say this. It is Swapnavat Mithya. You cannot say Jagrat and Swapna. You cannot equate. You cannot call Jagrat as having Pratibhasika Satta. This is their objection. Why? Otherwise, it will become Shunyavada. These people neither understand Shunyavada properly nor do they understand Vedanta properly. Unfortunate. Because they have been fed by Dvaitins. Dvaitins have objected. These people are unable to answer. If you want to answer Dvaitins, if that is your focus, study Tarka Shastra. Tarka Shastra is meant for you to debate. If you see, these people do not study Tarka Shastra. They question their own Advaitins because they own up the Dvaitins' doubts. They think that yes, it is all Buddhism. It is not Buddhism. Kshanika, Buddhism's, if you say it is Buddhism, Buddhists do not agree with you. Vedantins do not agree. Then who are you, the third person, the Dvaitin or an Advaitin, who has not understood either of the Pakshas? Why is he equating them? He is not, we need not answer that person at all. Because the objection is not valid from either of the Pakshas. Buddhists do not agree that it is same as Vedanta. Vedantins do not agree that it is same as Buddhism. Why? Who is this middleman who is creating confusion among others? Kshanika Vijnana by nature. We have seen earlier itself. Kshanika. Consciousness is Kshanika. The make and break is Chaitanya. We do not have anything other than Chaitanya. They don't have anything including Chaitanya. Huge difference, poles apart. They say very close. All these Westerners have some agenda to say that Buddhism, Vedanta has borrowed from Buddhism. Their focus is elsewhere. They want to destroy both. So all these people, whether they are Westerners or these so-called research scholars, all these may have a different agenda. It may be right or wrong from their perspective, but we have to hold on to our Siddhanta. We should not get confused that, oh, this is Buddhism. Bhagavan Bhashyakara says Buddhism will not lead to moksha because of being avaidika, Shraddha lacking. Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. Do you have Shraddha in Upanishad? Upanishad says this. Why do you have to equate with someone else who has borrowed from you and then destroyed that also and then claims authority over it? We separate them out. It is not useful for our own moksha sadhana. So mana eva sarvam ityadina chauktam. Nanu yadi jagadutpattihi akramena tarhi kimiti taitriyadishu krama ukta iti ched atra uchyate. It's a valid question. If somebody raises a doubt, an Advaitin says that there is a krama in Taittiriya Upanishad. Why do you say the Srishti is without krama? Yadi shrute he jagad utpatti vishe krama vivaksha syat tarhi shrutishu srishti kathane vaishamyam na syat bhavati tu drishyate tu vaishamyam. If the shruti had intention in talking about srishti as having a krama, then there won't be difference in various shrutis. Different shrutis talk about srishti in different ways. Tatha hi chandogye brahmana sakashad Agni Jala Prithvinam Kramena Utpattihi Shruyate. Trivitkaranam has been talked about there. Only three have been talked about in Chandogya Shastodya. Brahmana Sakashat. From Brahma, Agni Jala and Prithvi Kramena Utpadyante. So there is a Krama, a different Krama. First is Agni. There is no Akasha and Vayu, which is there in Taittiriya. So Taittiriya has Krama. That should be the Krama followed. Okay, you belong to the Taittiriya Shaka, you follow that. But go on, move on to Apavada. Don't get stuck and compare this with another Upanishad and say mine is right. There are people who have these debates. Which is the right Krama? Should it be Panchikaranam or Trivitkaranam? Which should be the right Krama? So there are people who hold on to one as superior to the other. Both are inferior because the Shruti says that there is no Tatparya there. There is an Apavada coming up. Tadaikshat Bahusyam Prajayeti Tattejo Srujata सो देयर इज अ क्रमा मेंशन्ड इन छांदोग्य इत्यादिना तैतरीये आकाश वायु अग्नि जल पृथ्वीनां पंचभूतानां क्रमेण उत्पत्ति श्रूयते वेर एस पंचीकरणम इज टॉक्ड अबाउट इन तैतरीय तस्माद् वा एतस्माद् आत्मनः आकाशसंभूतः आकाशाद् वायुः वायोरग्निः अग्नेरापः अद्भ्यः पृथिवी पृथिव्या औषधयः औषधीभ्योन्नम् अन्नात् पुरुषः सो देयर इज अ क्रमा देयर विथ स्टार्टिंग विथ आकाशः तस्माद् वा एतस्माद् आत्मना फ्रॉम दैट ब्रह्म आत्मा ब्रह्मात्मा आकाशः संभूतः न तु अग्निः विच इज द फर्स्ट पंचमहाभूत इट इज आकाश इन तैत्रीय अग्नि इन छांदोग्य देर आर ओनली थ्री इन छांदोग्य देर आर फाइव इन तैत्रीय सो भगवान भाष्यकर आंसर्स दैट क्वेश्चन सेइंग दैट अग्नि व्हेन यू से अग्नि कैनॉट बी देर विदाउट आकाश एंड वायु सो देर इज एन एजम्पशन मेड देर दिस इज एन आंसर गिवन देर दैट इज नॉट द रियल आंसर भगवान भाष्यकर रिजॉल्व्स द इशू यू हैव द ट्रबल दैट ओके मूव ऑन Why want to move on to Apavada? He says, you tag along with me any which way. I don't want this question to bother you anymore. So he resolves it by saying there are two preceding. Okay, is it convincing? Yes, let's move on. Then he lands the Shishya on the Apavada. Purva Pakshi should become the Shishya and land on Apavada. Kvachitcha Parameshwara Sarvam Asrujat Iti Kramam Antarayeva Utpatti Shruyate Like somewhere it has mentioned that all this in the same Upanishad also. Idam sarvam asrujata. So you move on to another in the same Upanishad or in the same Shaka. Vaishaka, same Upanishad across two adhyayas, 12 days. Idam sarvam asrujata. He created all this. Now the gap has to be bridged. So you can say he created all this means everything is created by Ishvara, not directly Kramena. This can be one answer. But the real answer is what? That Krama Bheda has purposely been put in the Shruti so that for an inquiring mind, he knows the Bheda and knows that there is no commitment here. You drop it. So what is the Tatparya? You move on and hunt for the Tatparya. That is Manana. Therefore, Krama is also dropped at places. Ityadina itham vedeshu jagad utpattehe nana prakarana varnanasya ayam ashayaha. What is the idea with explaining Shrishti differently in different Upanishads, different shakas, in different adhyayas? The idea is jagad mithya eva. Jagad is mithya. You know just by seeing that, oh, it can be this way, it can be that way. It is this way. How can it be both ways? Does not stand scrutiny. विचारं न सहते इत्थं वेदेषु जगदुत्पत्ते नाना प्रकारेण वर्णनस्य अयमाशय जगत् मिथ्या एव वस्तुभूतं चेत् जगत् स्यात् हैड दी जगत् बीन रियल क्रमा बीन रियल तदुत्पत्ति क्रमः वेदेषु अनेक प्रकारेण न उच्येत उच्यते तु वुडंट हैव बीन सेड बट इट इज सेड देयरफॉर मिथ्या देयर इज नो तात्पर्य There, vastuni vikalpa sambhavat. Why? Because you cannot have vastu this way and that way. Vasati iti vastu. If the vastu is this way, then you talk about in yathartha way. This is also yathartha, that is also yathartha. It cannot be. Vastuni vikalpasya vikalpanam asambhavat. You cannot have vikalpa in krama. If it is vastavika, vastu means vastavika. Is it vastavika? It has to be only one way, yathartha. It cannot be any other way. Ataha mithya. Atascha upanishadam jagadutpatti kramena tatparyam. Brahmana advitiyatva varnane paramatatparyat tadangatvena jagannishedasya vivakshidatvat nishedatvena आक्षिप्तस्य जगतः यथाकथञ्चित् आरोपः कर्तव्यः इत्येव तात्पर्यम् सो इन सम वे वी हैव टू एक्सप्लेन दि सृष्टि सो दैट यू लैंड ऑन दि तात्पर्य तात्पर्य विषय इज व्हाट ब्रह्मण अद्वितीयत्व वर्णनम् has never become something else. How can Srishti be real? So to talk about Brahma as Advitiya, the prapancha which is apparently real to the Shishya, there is a Jagat Pratiti, you have to do some hand-holding initially. So any which way you explain that out. Like you tell children. Children ask some questions, cannot be answered. In fact, the one who, wants to test the patient, real titiksha is to deal with a child. Many children, in fact. You deal with many children and try to answer all their questions. You have to cook up something. You have to bring up some stories, divert their attention. So you divert their attention to what is important. How do you do that? Somehow give some answer. So this is the Upanishad teaching us as children who keep on bringing up questions. We think we are inquiring minds. What inquiring minds? Where is the tatparya? That is the inquiry. To understand details of mithya, there is no tatparya there. It is losing your way. It is delicious. Yes, I want to know answers. The questions are encouraged. The right questions are encouraged. The parent knows what is an appropriate question. For the child to know the answer, what is an appropriate question in that age? So the answer has to fit that age. Adhikari bheda is there. Therefore, Brahmana advitiyatva varnane paramatatparya. Paramatatparya is that. Tadangatvena, but then Anga is there because we have to know the world. When I say who am I? Who am I has the question with who am I, who faces this prapancha, who created that prapancha, what is my sambandha with the prapancha, what is my sambandha with the prapancha karta, what is the sambandha between the prapancha and the prapancha karta. So I have to know all three and interrelations thereof. Therefore, tad angatvena, the real akanksha is to know me, but tad angatvena, Vishaya Chinta, Srishti Chinta. But then you should not stop with details, wanting to get lost in the details. Thereby, Yatha Katanchid Aropaha Kartavyaha. Somehow you explain it out. This is the, the Shruti is in a hurry to get to Tatparya really. But then she can't hurry. There are many questions. So the Upanishad gives answers somehow to get you there. Whatever works, that's why they say, whatever works for you, just get there. Whatever works, not by hook or crook, that kind of a thing, but is it acceptable? Okay. So why fight about it? So we compromise on something. You don't agree with it, but you compromise it because you want to reach where what is important. Do you agree? Okay, move on. Okay, I agree. Let's move on. So we move on and reach the real ground of inquiry. Tatrayam drishtantaha. Okay, I'll just finish this off quickly. Tatrayam drishtantaha leelartham kashchana kritriyam gajam nirmaya yantrena tamakashe utthapayati akasha gamana samaye tasya gajasya varnana karna vala dyavayaveshu vakrata sampattau tat samikaranaya sapurusho na prayatate evam eva brahmana advitiyatva jnana siddhaye etc. So the example given is Leelartham, just to play, someone, makes a balloon, an elephant shaped balloon or something, take a modern example, something. He shapes up the balloon in the form of an elephant or something and then lets it fly in the sky. When it's going up in the sky, let's say it changes shape. The ears are not this way, the leg is bent a little. This is all, for his play, he has done something. Now his focus is not there. He is not going to bring back and, trying to, what do I do about this now? So he may not fix it. Purusha na prayatati, the effort is not there. Evam eva, similarly, he wants to fly a balloon in the sky, fly a kite or something. But then, it should be exactly like this. No, his fun is just to see that it's flying in the sky. That's the fun. Thereby, that example drives home the point, where should be the commitment? एवमेव ब्रह्मण अद्वितीयत्व ज्ञान सिद्धे द्वैत रूपो दृश्य प्रपंच निषेधार्थं कल्पितः. तात्पर्य इज टू डू निषेध. सो यू ब्रिंग अप समथिंग जस्ट टू फाइनली एक्सप्लेन इट एज मिथ्या. तथा च भाष्ये प्रकृतैतावत्त्वाधिकारणे. सो इन ब्रह्मसूत्र वर्णितम इट इज एक्सप्लेन लोक प्रसिद्धं तु इदं रूपद्वयं ब्रह्मणी कल्पितं परामृशति प्रतिषेध्यत्वाय शुद्ध ब्रह्म स्वरूप प्रतिपादनाय च इति निरवध्यम् इति. सो इट इज डाउटलेस, इट इज देयर हैज शुड बी नो डाउट एज टू व्हाट इज दी तात्पर्य श्रुति. दिस लोक प्रसिद्धं तु इदं रूपद्वयं ब्रह्मणी कल्पितं परामृशति प्रतिषेध्यत्वाय. फाइनली it should be negated. Anything that is talked about is negated. Neti neti is the prakriya to land on Shuddha Brahma. So Shuddha Brahma Swarupa Pratipadanaya cha iti niravadyam. There is no flaw there. To bring it up, it has been brought up because it has to be negated to show the aikya. Tasmat shruti naam prapancha vishaye anadarad. There is no commitment there. If you hold on to prapancha vishaya, why does it? Oh, there is no adara there at all. Tad utpatti kramasya eka vidatvena varnane na yatnaha. There is no effort made to explain why it is so. Because the difference is to drive home the point that it is mithya. Tad utpatti vishaya shruti naam vigana darshana deva prapancha nishedeva shruti naam nairvhayam न तदुत्पत्तौ इति ज्ञेयम्. सो विल रिविजिट अ लिटिल बिट ओवरशॉट द टाइम एनी बट रिविजिट इन सेंस द आइडिया इफ इट इज क्लियर वी डोंट नीड टू रिविजिट एनीवेज. सो तदुत्पत्ति विषये श्रुतीनां विगान दर्शनादेव प्रपंच निषेधः. प्रपंच निषेध एव श्रुतीनां नैर्भयम् न तदुत्पत्तौ इति ज्ञेयम्. देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली फियरलेसली यू कैन से इट इज ऑल मिथ्या बिकॉज नन ऑफ दिस दिस विगाना इज निंदा निंदा दर्शनात् बिकॉज द्वैत निंदा इज डन एंड दैट इज ऑल्सो लिंग इट इज अर्थवाद. दि निंदा इज थ्रू नहि निंदा न्याय. The commitment is not there. Ninda is done so that you focus not there. Why Ninda is done? No, the Shruti should talk about the Shruti in this manner. The Acharya also should talk about Shruti with respect. All this, these ideas are there. That is why Ninda is done. This Ninda is done so that you know, understand Nahi Ninda Nyaya. You focus back on the Tatparya. Don't inquire there. Don't waste your time there. Get to the important part. Therefore, this विगान दर्शनादेव प्रपंच निषेध एव श्रुतीनां नैर्भयं न तदुत्पत्तौ इति ज्ञेयम्. द कमिटमेंट इज ओनली इन दि न तदुत्पत्तौ. इट इज इन दि तात्पर्य विच इज अद्वितीय ब्रह्म. सो दैट इज दि 253rd आवर्त. विल लुक एट इट मोर. विल कंटिन्यू इन 254. आई थिंक वी डिड दि टिप्पण. ओके सो विल कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम 254 इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. सुख नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृप्यत्वेन अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परम तदेव अन्नमत्वं यद्विशतामतिः. नमस्ते. विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट.
नमस्ते.
एनी क्वेश्चन? नो क्वेश्चंस.